So if we look at the latest IMF projections, global growth is expected to slow down in 2023, mostly due to advanced economies. Meanwhile, emerging markets should remain broadly stable, mainly thanks to the emerging Asian economies and the reopening of China. So we believe this EM developed markets growth differential should widen, and it should be supportive of risk assets in emerging markets. Well, inflation has been up in emerging markets as in developed markets. However, we believe that now we have seen the peak in inflation rates, and it should be supported going forward due to the base effects as from the second quarter of 2023. And we also have a more benign commodity environment, and supply chain pressures are easing. So we see that the pace of disinflation across emerging markets is accelerating, and we believe that at the end of the year, inflation should be lower in those countries. Well, we don't see a broad wave of defaults across emerging markets, and the issues are mostly concentrated in the lower credit and smaller issuers in emerging markets. Those issuers are well known, and they have been borrowing too much over the past few years and needed access to the market to be able to refinance their debt. Now that if you look at the yields on the secondary markets, you see that they are shut down from refinancing on those markets. And we believe that all those issues are well flagged for now, and actually some of those are already embarked on the restructuring process of their debt. So we don't see a contagion spreading to bigger EMs, which have access to international markets or are able to tap their domestic markets to refinance themselves. So we see value in countries which have stronger fundamentals and which have been proactive in fighting inflation, for instance. We do like countries where real yields are already high, even before the drop in inflation that we expect. So those countries are to be found, for instance, in LATAM, like Brazil, Mexico, Uruguay, or in Asia. We do like Indonesia, for instance, which have managed to keep inflation low over the past few years, and it should be soon back into the target of the central bank. Well, we are still at a preliminary stage of ESG in emerging markets, but we believe there is a huge potential for improvement there, and this is our role as ESG investors to help them when we engage with those issuers to explain to them what matters for investors. For instance, if we think of green bonds, we can help them understand what are our concerns regarding the green bond frameworks when they issue, for instance. So when we invest in emerging markets, we start from 90 issuers as per the IMF definition of developing and emerging economies. We apply our proprietary model, which assesses the ESG credentials of countries using 50 to 60 criteria issued by independent bodies. We rank them based on their relative score. We have those rankings of the ESG in emerging market countries. We split them in quartiles. The rule of the fund is that we have to invest at least 40% in the first quartile countries, with a maximum of 10% in the countries in the bottom quartile. So we believe that given the high carry that the asset class and the fund exhibits, it should be a driver of returns going forward. It provide a buffer for any duration or currency losses. which make us quite confident about the outlook for this asset class. And in terms of allocation, we will stick with our philosophy to focus on countries with stronger fundamentals, less vulnerabilities, and which have proven credible policy making.